Klodd, and I'm an extension educator in fruit and vegetable production at the University of Minnesota. Today, I'm out at University of Minnesota's Horticultural Research Center, where we grow apple trees for research. So today, we will be showing how to prune an apple tree. You might have an apple tree in your backyard, or you're thinking about planting one. If so, this video is for you. We'll show you how to prune an apple tree to produce high-quality apples. We'll be talking about this in a three-part series today. First, why we prune and the tools we use for pruning. Second, how to assess a tree and then prune for diseased, damaged, and dead limbs. And third, how to prune for tree shape and fruit quality. So you have an apple tree in your backyard and it's a big, beautiful tree. Why do we bother pruning it every year? There are a few reasons why it's important to prune apple trees every year. One of those is that we want to remove what we call the three D's, the diseased, dead, and damaged wood from the tree. The second one is because we want to maintain that nice tree shape from year to year. And what we're going for is a conical shape to the tree. The third reason is that pruning helps us produce high quality fruit from year to year. So the second question then is, why are we out here in winter in the middle of February when it's cold? Why can't we wait to prune in the summer when it's warm? And what we want to go for is pruning towards the end of the winter when a lot of those really cold temperatures have already passed, but we don't want to wait so long that the trees have started coming out of dormancy and producing buds. And this helps us prevent the most winter injury to our trees. I'm here today with David Bedford, who is a research scientist in the Apple Group at University of Minnesota. Thanks for joining me today, David.
Oh, my pleasure.
Appreciate it. And we'll be pruning this apple tree together today. David, can you show us the tools that you use to prune when you come out here?
Well, I'd be happy to. There are three tools that we actually use. I'll give you the bucket here. I'm going to start with the smallest and simplest of the three, and that's just a pair of hand pruning shears. These are quite common. We prefer the type that's actually a bypass, and we can talk about that at some other point. But these will handle any of the small branches, anything up to, probably 3/4 of an inch or maybe the size of your index finger. So next, when we have to deal with the little larger branches, which you can see in this tree, there are plenty of, we'll go to the long-handled loppers. This is sort of a mega version of those little hand shears and gives us much more leverage and allows us to cut limbs up to, probably an inch or an inch and a half diameter. And then when we get into the big ones, you'll see there's plenty of those too, then we'll use a pruning saw. And this saw is meant specifically for pruning trees, but actually many types of saws can be used on that. So these three tools should pretty much handle everything I think we'll face in this tree today.
All right, thanks. In the next section, we'll be describing how to assess a tree for pruning, and then we will actually start using these tools to prune off the dead, damaged, and diseased limbs.